Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Skill RPA. So this video is like completely towards regarding the templates. So when we're starting our project, when we are trying to create our own project, like we can see a couple of templates here, right? Like the process, library, test automation, and even we can build our own template for the project. And also we have RE framework, which is a template, and the background process, and we can see more and more templates here. So all these templates are to start with your project. Like when you are starting or when you are trying to create your project, at that time we will be picking up these templates. But because that template is facilitating you by default, a couple of features which it's not necessary for you to build every time. As part of your project. If you take the example of RE framework, you have all the states defined and the transitions from one state to the other state and the logging and the try catch and all these things are like already in place. When we are creating a project, for the project, you have a template. And inside of our project, we will be creating a couple of, we will be creating workflows, right? It can be a sequence or a flowchart or state machines or a workflow or a test case. Test case will come into the picture when you are dealing with UiPath test suite. And in other scenarios, like we will be having only till the workflow. So let us suppose, let me create a sequence. I'll just keep the name as it is. And I have try catch. And a log message. Execution started for sequence. The same log message at this particular place. Completed. Sequence. And also in the catch block, let us suppose I have one more log message here. Exception dot message. So this is a placeholder for logic. So this is my workflow. I'll be doing performing some actions here. Whatever the exception is coming, like I'll be catching here. So let us suppose I want to build one more sequence and only the logic in between is changing. So again, I need to drag and drop this activity, try catch and the log message and all these things again, or else I just need to copy from here and I need to paste it there, right? So we need to do this much circus. So instead of that, what we can do is we can just, if you see here, extract as a template. So we'll click on that and we can say build template for sequence and click on create. So this is my template. And if you see here, under the templates, this was got placed. Okay, and we can even directly right click here and we can click on this and we can just write workflow template. So either we can extract a sequence with the basic, whatever the structure we are thinking of to have as a basic point for each and every sequence we are going to build in this process, or we can even create from here as well. So let us suppose, when I want to create some new sequence, a new workflow for my project, instead of sequence, now what I will do is I'll just click on this workflow and create it with workflow template. And here under the templates, we can select either we want to create like sequence, a flowchart, or like whatever we defined build template for the sequence. If I click on create, whatever is there in the template, that will be immediately get reflected here. So I can just continue writing in my code so that like for each and every sequence, whatever we are going to build in our process, we can have this template created for us, and we can utilize that to save our development time. And is it the only thing? So we'll try to create a test case. If you see right here, we have BDD test case. So we'll click on create. So we got like given, when, and then. This is the basic test case, whatever we have. Empty test case. So which will like give you a simple sequence. And in terms of test case, right? Let us suppose I want to have a log message. Execution started for test case. And I have a try catch. And I'll take a verification expression. And in the catch block, so I developed my test case, and I'll be having some placeholder also here. Placeholder for test case. So this is my test case, which I want to have for all of my test cases, which I am going to build in this process. So in that case, what I will do is I'll just come here, this test case to, I'll right click on this, and I'll just click on this extract as a template and click on create. So this is my template. And now when I'm trying to create a test case here, from here, I can check, see, I could able to see this test case 2 template. And my test case 3 will be with the similar structure. So I can just simply write my logic, whatever I want to implement for this particular test case. So like we just need to consolidate what is our basic structure and what is the things going on, like going to be changed in terms of when we are creating a workflow or a test case. So in this way, we can build all those things. And if you see here, we created 2 templates, which is test case template and the workflow template. And we can create this execution template as well. So to see that, let us click on this execution template. We'll click on create. So this is my execution template. And I just want to write some log message. We can build any of the parameters as well. Info, click on this. Execution template started. And I'll just put one more log message here. Executions template completed. So I just created one execution template, and let us see, I'll just run this workflow test case 3, run the file. And we'll see what actually we are getting it here. If you see the output panel, we have execution started for the test case and the verification is true. So whatever we have in the test case 3, everything is got executed. And what I will do is for test case 3, I'll right click here and I'll just click on this set execution template. And from here, I'll just select the whatever the execution template which I created, click on OK. And now what we will do is we will run this test case 3 and we will see what we are going to get. If you see here, right, execution template started and execution template completed. So we got these 2 additional log messages apart from these 2 which we saw previously. So which means when we are trying to execute this test case with the help of this execution template, so whatever the test case we are executing, right, it will be kind of in this will be invoked here. So whatever the placeholder we have here, right, so this invoke of test case 3 will be replaced while we are executing the workflow. Like it won't be really available, but when we are running it under this execution template, this workflow will be invoked in this placeholder in the runtime. And for a sequence, we have created a sequence, right? For sequences, we cannot set the execution templates because execution templates are for running the test cases. But when you are trying to create the workflows, at that time, we can utilize this workflow template and the test case templates. And the execution template is to execute your test case based on some parameters. Like in case if you want to have some data, we can put the data, or some if you want to put some validations, we can put that. So based on how you want to have this execution, we can put these things. Hope you are clear about these execution templates, and we can leverage these execution templates or whatever the templates, build templates, whatever we have, and we can leverage that in order to reduce our development effort and speed of implementation. And we can just avoid the copy paste from one sequence to the other sequence by having these execution templates. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to Skill RPA YouTube channel and hit the bell icon.